that Washington and Colorado led the nation in regards to the legalization of cannabis in a recreational capacity and so forth. So we could be considered leaders, if you will, and people that are understand how to separate the cannabis out in a way to minimize criminal activity and to regulate it in a way that gives the most protection with regards to health care and those kinds of things, pesticides and that. How do you approach or communicate with other people, countries and or cities, states, if you will, that are thinking about legalization? Because I'm sure you get a lot of inquiries.
Well, we do. And, you know, I like to tell the staff that they're pioneers, because Colorado and Washington were the first two states. And I often like to joke also that I wish we hadn't been. I wish we would have had it. I wish we would have had like Oregon, Oregon and Alaska and Maine and Massachusetts and now California. They got a little bit of a roadmap from both Colorado and Washington.
Yeah, that's
so 18 countries have visited us in some shape or fashion. A lot of folks from Canada and the provinces. We talked about best practices. I think when you talk about packaging and labeling and testing and potency and the rest of it, that's why I say they're different. I think I'll say this. I say it all over the state and the country is, I think we have the most tightly regulated, restricted marketplace in the country. Part of it has to do with what we talked about with the separation of the tiers.
And does anybody else do that, by the way?
They do not. We're the only one that doesn't allow vertical integration. You know, in a way, I'd like to brag about that, but I can tell you that those restrictions make it difficult for the business community because it's very expensive. But I would say we're pretty strictly regulated. We do 3 to 4 compliance checks on all youth compliance checks on all our retailers. Our youth compliance rate is somewhere around 92% to 94%, higher than it is for alcohol. So we do a good job of trying to keep it out of the hands of kids.
Yeah, but also it sounds to me with the vertical desegregation, if you will, it also minimizes the amount of criminal organized criminal activity that can possibly
occur. Well, it's a pretty vetted system as far as you go through a criminal background check with us and a fingerprint with the State Patrol and the FBI. We do a financial investigation of where you got the money. You have to open your bank accounts to us so we can see. So there's a vetting process. It is why we've had success in banking, is because the retail licensee signs a waiver that allows us to give the licensing file to the bank so they can see how we vetted them to be licensees, to get to your point, to making sure that the criminal element isn't involved in this business. You know, that's the biggest piece.
So what, any change of ownership along the way?
They do. Any investment, any money that comes in, they're also vetted. But I think it gets back to your point. Yeah. Was the war on drugs a failure or not? I think for most people, it's why you've seen the change in policy around the states. People believe it failed. People believe that, for the most part, people of color have been incarcerated or been vulnerable to what's happened from a social justice point of view and a criminal justice point of view. The people in Washington, you know, 56-44%, which is similar to the other states, voted to legalize. Don't forget that we still have 44% of the voting population that said no. So there's
that's
an incredible balance.
That's one of the reasons we
there's
have
a balance
trouble.
There.
Exactly. The people that don't really understand.
So you've got the feds saying it's illegal. You've also got almost half of your voting population say, I'm not feeling real good about this policy shift that you made. So we always, as a regulator, have to balance those that are so happy to see the product legal with making sure that it's strictly regulated. And I think this staff has done a great job. This agency, it's had nothing to do with me, has done a great job of trying to make sure that this industry is regulated strictly so that we don't have the feds come in and tear the system down.
So given that cannabis is leading the way, if you will, with regards to legalization and recreational and medicinal purposes and so forth, and I think Amsterdam, Holland actually led the world with regards to legalizing drugs. It has been said over and over again in many areas that when you legalize the drug or the cannabis, you minimize create money to help addiction issues and so forth.
Right.
So what about seeing out into the future about legalization of all drugs to minimize and to address that, because the war on drugs really has been lost. Right. And what do we do? It is a movement, so to speak.
Right.
I think Milton Friedman actually said that many years ago when I was in college, that legalize them and we can tax them.
Well, let me throw this one out because I've been thinking about it. We legalized opiates in this country, and we've got a scourge. You know, we've got a real problem.
Yeah.
In fact, a lot of people are saying they're using cannabis as a way of dealing with some of the issues that they're having, because at least it's a different approach that's a little healthier than
the pain
pain relief. Just because we've legalized a drug, my point is, doesn't necessarily mean it's going to make things better, because we've seen the opiate crisis that's going on in the country, because for many years we were overprescribing painkillers and people are addicted. And in fact, we had a lot of medical patients who have come forward to say, you're not going to believe it. I can actually feel like I have a day to day. I'm going to be able to enjoy the day to day because I'm not basically doped up in the same way that I was when I was stuck on OxyCotton and all of the
opiates. What you're saying, though, is that cannabis is,
I mean, we have to be careful.
The recreational and medicinal cannabis has actually changed our view on a lot of things.
Well, we've been told that it's made a lot of difference for a lot of people.
Well, thank you so much.
We'll make that the final word. Thank you,
Rick,
for your time.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Nice to see you guys.
It's been wonderful.